households, both alike in dignity. In fair Verona, where we lay our scene, from ancient grudge break to new mutiny, where civil blood makes civil hands unclean. From forth the fatal loins of these two foes, a pair of star-crossed lovers take their life, whose misadventured piteous overthrows do with their death bury their parents' strife. The fearful passage of their death-marked love and the continuance of their parents' rage, which, but their children's end not could remove, is now the 2 hours' traffic of our stage. The which if you with patient ears attend, what here shall miss? Our toil shall strive to mend.
Thank you. know not what you do. What? Art thou drawn amongst these harmless hinds? Turn thee, Benvolio. Look upon thy death.
I do keep the peace. Put up thy sword, or manage to part these men with me.
What? Drawn and speak of peace? I hate the word, as I hate hell, all Montagues and thee. Have at the coward.
Montague have thrice disturbed the quiet of our streets. If ever you disturb our streets again, your lives shall pay the forfeit of the peace. For this time, all the rest depart away. Once more, by pain of death, all men depart.
Thank you. how stands your disposition to be married?
It is an honor that I dream not of.
An honor? Were not I thine only nurse, I would say thou hast sucked the wisdom from my teeth. Well, think of marriage now. Younger than you here in Verona, ladies of esteem are made already mothers. By my count, I was your mother much upon these years that you are still a maid. Thus then in brief, the valiant Paris seeks you for his love.
A man, lady, he's such a man as all the world. Why, he's a man of wax.
Verona's summer had not such a flower.
Nay, he's a flower, to say, a very flower.
Speak briefly. Can you like a Paris love?
I'll look to like if looking liking move. But no more will I endart to mine eye than your consent gives strength to make it fly.
Thank you. Thank you. I have seen the day when I have worn a visor and could tell a whispering tale to a fair lady's ear, such as would please. Oh, it is gone, it is gone, it is gone. Welcome, gentlemen. Ladies that have toes unplanted with thorns will have a bout with you. You are welcome, gentlemen. Come, musicians, play!
Thank you. gentle fine is this? My lips, two blushing pilgrims ready stand, to smooth that rough touch with a tender kiss.
Good pilgrim, you do wrong your hand too much. For saints have hands that pilgrims' hands do touch, and palm to palm is holy palmers kiss.
Have saints not lips and holy palmers too?
Aye, pilgrim, lips that they must use in prayer.
Oh, then, dear saint, let lips do what hands do. Thus, from my lips, by yours, my sin is purged.
Then have my lips the sin that they have took.
Sin from thy lips? Oh, trespass, sweetly urged, give me my sin again.
You kiss by the book.
Thank you. Thank you.
light through yonder window breaks. It is the east, and Juliet is the sun. It is my lady. Oh, it is my love. Oh, that she knew she were. See how she leans her cheek upon that hand. Oh, that I were a glove upon that hand, that I might touch that cheek.
Oh, Romeo, Romeo.
Thank you.
follow me closely, for I will speak to them. Gentlemen, to a den, a word with one of you.
And but one word with one of us. Couple it with something. Make it a word and a blow.
I am for you.
Gentle Mercutio, put that rapier up.
Come, sir, your posado.
Tis not so deep as a well, nor so wide as a church door. But tis enough. Oh, sir, ask for me tomorrow, and you will find me a grave man. I am peppered, I quarred for this world. Soon's a dog, a rat, a cat, a mouse to scratch a man to death. A braggart, a rogue, a villain that fights by the book of arithmetic. Why the devil you came between us? I was hurt under your arm. I thought all for the best. A plague of both your houses. They have made worms meat of me. I have it. And soundly too. Your houses!
Thank you.
My dismal needs, I must act alone. Come!
All things that we ordained festival turn from their office to black funeral, our instruments to melancholy bells, our wedding cheer to a sad burial feast, our solemn hymns to sullen dirges change, our bridal flowers serve for a buried cause, and all things change them to the contrary.
But I ask again, for nothing can be ill if she be well.
Then she is well, and nothing can be ill. Her body sleeps in Capel's monument, and her immortal part with angels lives.
Is even so?
And I defy you, stars!
Thank you.
A glooming peace this morning with it brings. The sun for sorrow will not show his head. Go hence to have more talk of these sad things. Some shall be pardoned, and some punished. For never was a story of more woe than this of Juliet and her Romeo.